of your names. My name is Brother Baker, Preacher Baker, Pastor Baker, you know, which might want to say, old man. I've been doing this now with Bible school probably at least 37 years. And some of the adults sitting here were once little boys and girls like you. And now they have children. So we're going to have a great week, a wonderful time. You just have to pay attention. Two things. Pay attention and participate. Out here and into your craft classes out there in the dining hall. We're going to have a great time this week. And so we're going to go ahead and have prayer. And then we're going to have our pledges. And then we'll have our penny contest. Okay? All right. Let's bow our heads. Let's pray and ask God to bless the service. Lord Jesus, thank you for every young man and young lady that's here. Thank you for the children that are here, dear God, the little ones. Thank you, dear God, for the workers that have come to give their time to help out in Bible school. And I sure pray, Holy Spirit, you'll have your way in here tonight and in the craft classes, that, Lord, everybody will behave and listen, participate. Give us a good spirit. In thy name we pray. Amen. Now, you'll see what we got up here. You're going to hear about all 10 of these things this week. All right? But right now, we're going to do our pledges. For those who may not know the pledges, we're going to put them on the wall up here, okay? And to the American flag, let's stand up to our feet, okay? And it'll go something like this. I'll say attention, that means stand up. I'll say salute, you put your hand on your heart. I'll say pledge, and you say the pledge to the American flag. You ready? Attention and salute and pledge. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Amen. Y'all did real good, kids. All right. Here's our Bible now, the Christian flag. All right. And this is the Christian flag, red, white, and blue, red, white, and blue. You ready? The Christian flag, attention, salute, and pledge. I pledge allegiance to the Christian flag and to the Savior for whose kingdom it stands. One Savior, crucified, risen, and coming again with life and liberty for all who believe. Amen. That's right. And now we're going to say our pledge to the Bible, God's Word. Get this up here. Next year, we're going to have something different. We're going to get modernized next year. Amen. Now the Bible. You ready? Attention, salute, and pledge. I pledge allegiance to the Bible, God's holy word. I will make it a lamp unto my feet, a light unto my path. I hide its words in my heart, that I might not sin against God. Amen. All right, you can be seated. All right. Well, as you know, every year we have our penny contest. And we need to slide these out of the way here just a little bit. And, well, that ain't going to work, is it? All right. Okay. Who you think's going to win the contest this year? Hey, all right. We'll see you in just a few moments, okay? Well, last year, the boys won. But this year, it might be different, okay? And let's stand to our feet. How many of you know the song? All right, some of you know it. Now listen, everybody has to participate, even you teenagers and even you adults, okay? It's a fun time. Some of you teenagers do some crazy things in life. So here, have a good time. Go back to your childhood a little bit. It's not on Facebook. Nobody's going to see it. Nobody's going to know that you're doing this, okay? All right, you ready? All right, Miss Baker, you ready? Let me show you how it goes, okay? Go ahead. It's a penny, it's a penny, it's a penny, penny, penny contest. With the boys against the girls, we're all in a twirl. It's a penny, penny, penny contest. see, I did that in slow motion. I'm the fastest spinner there is. I'm so fast you wouldn't think I'd done it. Huh? All right. You got it? You ready? Here we go. It's a penny, it's a penny, it's a penny, penny, penny contest. With the boys against the girls, we're all in a twirl. It's a penny, penny, penny contest. Do it one more time. It's a penny. It's a penny, penny, penny contest. I think we can do better now. I think we can speed it up a little bit, okay? You ready? It's a penny, it's a penny, it's a penny, penny, penny contest. With the boys against the girls, we're all in a twirl. It's a penny, penny, penny contest. I think we can get faster. I think we can speed it up. All right, here we go. It's a penny, it's a penny, it's a penny, penny, penny contest. With the boys against the girls, we're all in a twirl. Well, I'm tired now. I done spun around and got a little bit woozy. So we got to slow it down, Miss Baker. Slow it down, Brother Baker's age is catching up with me. Let's slow it down. Ready? It's a penny, it's a penny, it's a penny, penny, penny contest. With the boys against the girls, all in a twirl. It's a penny, penny, penny contest. All right. What we're going to do is, as she plays, front row right here, girls, come and put your pennies in. All right. Second row, second row. Come on, girls. A penny. No, no, not yet, not yet, not yet. Third row, next row. Uh-huh. Everybody else? Rest of you? You ready? Oh boy. Is that it? Is that all the girls? All right. We got more, Miss Williams. Here comes Miss Williams. I'm telling you what now. All right. Yes, ma'am. Woo! How about that? All right, boys, here we go. Right here, front row. Front row. All right, there you go. Hey, girls, it's looking good, girls. Looking good. All right, boys, rest of you, come on. All right, come on. There you go, there you go. I just wonder who's going to win.
Probably the boys.
All right. Okay. All right, rest of you. Rest of you got any pennies? There you go. Come on.
Preacher, I think you ought to look
with
this
hour. All right. Now, notice the teenage girls and boys didn't have any pennies. So what happens if you don't give pennies, we charge you $5 to get out. All right. I need some muscle up here. Give me two girls. All right, I need some muscle. I need somebody on this side. I wonder who's going to win. Hold a second. Hold on. Let me see. Oh, it's going to be close, I'm telling you. All right, fellas, put them up there. Amen. All right, you got to stop it from wiggling. You didn't hear me? Oh, my. Are you ready? I wonder which side's going to go down. Girls. You ready? You ready? One, two, three. All right. Take them off, boys. Come get them. All right. Well, I tell you what, that's good. We got four more nights to go. Amen. What a blessing. Okay. Well, I'll tell you what we're going to do. We're going to let the little ones go to their classes now. 4 to 6 year old, go to your classes and have a great time. You're going to have a wonderful time in there. All right. Okay. All right, now listen. Remember what I said. Now, we got a lot more girls than we got boys. We'll have to even it out in a few moments, okay? Okay? Listen up. We're going to sing a song in a few minutes, okay? And, all right. Let's see here. Let me get this song lined up. It's a penny. It's a penny contest. Boy against the girls. What in the world is that? What is this, man? What are you doing with your mouth taped up? I can see. Well, you can't communicate with your mouth. No, you can't. That means that you are crazy. I know somebody else that needs to do that. There's a lot of people need to do that. Amen? Huh? And, well, how tall are you? I know you're that tall, but how tall is that? See? You're just taller than me? Yeah. Are you just the silent man? Is that what you are? Just a silent man? You don't want to talk? A little bit? Talk. Huh? I don't understand the words you're saying. But listen, you know where heaven is? You know where hell is? All right. Well, how do you get to heaven? Pray. Yeah, give him your heart. Yeah. Who? Him. Oh, heaven. The man in heaven comes into your heart. That's how you get it. Okay. That's pretty good, ain't it? Yeah? Listen, are you married? Oh. He's married. You have any children? Grandchildren? Wow. No wonder you got your mouth taped up. Well, and what do you do for a living? You have to drive to work. What subject you teach? You teach, don't you? All right. Where do you live? Over there? Okay. Not far from here? Okay. So you're a Christian? Oh, I like that. Well, that's wonderful. I'm glad you're a Christian. Oh, and how old are you? No. I don't. How many is that? 100. 40 what? 40. 100. Oh. 100. He don't look 100. No, he don't look 100. Will you come to enjoy Bible school? Did you enjoy that pizza? Yeah. Well, listen here, silent man. You know, it's one thing to be silent, but there's times you need to speak up. Yeah, you know, share things and don't be so, yeah. There's things you need to share. You don't need to be quiet all the time. To be quiet, there's a time to speak up. Huh? Yeah. So if you're a Christian, you will not be silent about that. And if you're, you know, if you love the Lord, you ought not be quiet about that. You ought to be let people know that you're a Christian and let, how they can be a Christian. And you can't do that being silent. See? There are some things you need to be silent about. So you do some things you need to talk. Oh, yeah. Well, maybe you can tell us some things since you're a Christian. Amen? Go ahead.
Christian, the Bible says, mess it with your mouth. Which means you have to open it. Oh, so there are times when you need to open your mouth. My wife has that one figured out. Okay. But in other words, if you are in a burning building, should you stay there? No, okay, you should go where? To the place that is not on fire, that'd be good. Now, if you could get to the place that was not on fire, would it be good to say, mention to anybody else in the building that, hi, the building's on fire, follow me. Would that be good?
Yeah, that'd be great.
Would it work with tape on your mouth?
No.
Oh, guess what? If hell is on fire, and you know how to not go there, wouldn't it be a good thing to open your mouth and tell somebody?
Yeah.
Oh. In other words, it's good to be saved. It's good to have Jesus in your heart. It's good to have faith, and it's good to know how to go to heaven. It's good to know that you're going to heaven. It's better to let somebody else know so they can go too.
Try. Amen. That's good. Thank you, Solid Man. Isn't that good? All right. Amen. All right. We'll try to have a different character every night. All right, we're going to sing a song here. We sang this song last year. It did real good. And we're going to try it again this year. Mr. Lamb's going to come to the piano. And we're going to sing this song. It's called Happy Am I. Are you happy? Now, some of you are happy because you're out of school. Some of you are happy because you have a boyfriend. Or a girlfriend, or you don't have any boyfriend or girlfriend. Some of you are happy just because you got your own bedroom, or you know, you're just happy. But you ought to be happy because you're saved, if you are saved. And if you're not saved, we're going to tell you how you can be saved before you leave tonight. All right? So, I'm happy, happy, happy. All right, let's stand to our feet. And Mr. Lamb is going to play this song. We are going to sing it now, okay? All right, here we go. Here we go. Happy am I, Jesus is mine forever, never to leave, always in each endeavor leading me on, in life ending never, giving a smile ever of mine. Oh, happy am I, happy am I, all of my sins forgiven. These days I'll be enjoying heaven now that I know upward I'll go. Oh, happy am I, happy am I. How can I help but shout it every day, telling this world about it? Jesus is real. All who believe, don't doubt it. Then you will be happy like me. Oh, happy am I. All right, Miss Baker, you come and get this microphone. All right, here we go. All right, here we go. Brother Brian, you come and get this microphone. Okay. All right, there we go. Now you're going to have to help these boys and girls sing this song. Huh? Huh?
Make those words bigger?
Can I make them bigger?
Well,
poof. They're bigger. They're not bigger.
You can't make it.
I can't make it bigger. I can make it bigger tomorrow night. Okay.
Well, I just thought they might be helpful.
Yeah. Are you married? To who? All right, let's sing it again. Here we go. Here we go. Get your microphone.
Happy am I. Jesus is mine forever, ever to lead. All within each and every living beyond.
Seated. That's great, kids. I tell you what, by the end of the week, you'll be zooming with that song. You really will be zooming with that song. All right. Just put it up over there, sweetheart. All right. Mm-hmm. Okay. We're going to sing another song now. Yeah, here we go. All right. We're going to sing this song here. Jesus in the morning, all day long. Amen. I just want to let you sit down so you can learn it, okay? You ready to be amen? All right, look at the words. Here we go. Let's stand up and sing it. Here we go. All right. Everybody participate now. Participate. That's good.
Jesus, Jesus, Jesus in the morning, Jesus at the noontime. Jesus, Jesus, Jesus when the sun goes down. Praise Him, praise Him, praise Him in the morning, praise Him at the noontime. Praise Him, praise Him, praise Him when the sun goes down.
can be seated. That's wonderful. Yes, sir, that's wonderful. You know, when I think about that song and what it tells us is how thankful you should be. And this week we're going to talk about these 10 things. Later we're going to talk about these. These are just 10. There's many more than this. But if you have a home, you ought to thank God every day. If you're saved, you ought to thank God every day. If you've got just a little bit of an education, thank the Lord. Clothes on your back, food, so much to be thankful for, okay? All right, well, I think we're going to have a contest right now. Let me look here and make sure. Oh, yes. Okay, now, the winner of this contest will get 6 rolls of pennies put in their bucket. All right? This is called the peanut pass. Yes. Okay, here's what we're going to do. Since we have more girls than boys, I'm going to have to do something. Okay? All right, let's see here. How are we going to do this? I don't know what we can do. All right, huh? Let's see, we got twice as many girls, it looks like, as boys. Huh? Yeah, well, okay. I tell you what, let's do. You teenage boys, come up one row. Come up one row, okay? Come up one row. All right, just fall right in there. All right. You know, he just sit right on the inmate, folks stomp all over your feet. That's real smart. Yeah, there you go. All right. Okay. That's good. All right. I need Christy, Brandy, Miss Williams, come over and help me be on the boys' team. Sit right here, right beside Chris. You three, come on. Miss Williams, you come and help out. This is something you can do. Amen. She said, I got to help them boys. Miss Baker, you and Miss Judy come over here and help out on this side. Miss Baker rigs it. No, she won't rig it. All right, sit, fill up these her pews right here. Okay, there we go. Now. All right, what I need to do to sort of even it out now, that's pretty close, isn't it? That pretty close? Yeah. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 4. No, it's not close either. 4 to 3. All right. Why don't you adult ladies come to this front pew? Miss Nancy, y'all come up here. There you go. Now that might even it out a little bit. Yeah. Deborah, come up here. Come up here. Now. No, Angie, you got to come back over here. Now that should even it out. Now, there you go. All right. No, you can't do that. You've got to get them, you got to get these 3 pews. You got to fill these 3 pews. Tommy, come up here and help out. All right, girls. 1, 2, 3. All right, you girls come up here. You girls on that end, come up here, girls.
That's right.
Fill in that second pew.
Ryan, get out the PA.
No, he needs to stay in the PA.
Ryan?
Yeah, you.
What are we doing?
I need an adult right here on this end. I need an adult right here on this end.
Okay.
Right, you got to fill this pew up right here, girls. All right, now y'all go fill in right here. Come right in. No. Caroline, y'all stay seated. Are you ready? You ready? Hold that bucket. All right, you listen to me now. You listen to me. All right. You need to slide in. You need to sit right here. I need an adult right here. There you go. Now, Miss Kathy, Tommy, I don't know how many peanuts are in here. One at a time. You got to pass that peanut. Give her another one. Now, if you drop it, don't waste time picking it up. You're going to have 2 minutes to pass as many peanuts down. Back. Okay.
Oh, no.
What's the matter?
I want to hold the bucket.
Pass it down all the way to her. Pass it down all the way. Hey, you got to hold the bucket now. All right. Now, here's what you got to do. At the end of 2 minutes, whoever has the most peanuts in their container wins.
Okay.
Let me get my watch ready. Synchronized. You boys ready? How many rolls of pennies you get?
Six.
One at a time. You can't do but one at a time. If you drop it, I wouldn't. Just don't worry about it if you drop it. Just don't drop many. Well, no, not yet. I got this here $1,000 watch that I got to get lined up. All right, you ready? Set. Go. One at a time. Praise Him. Praise Him. Praise Him in the backyard. Praise Him. Praise Him when the sun goes down. Here they come. Here they come. Here they come. Hurry, hurry, hurry. Pass them peanuts. Pass them, pass them. You better hurry up. One at a time. Hurry up. This is the peanut. Hurry, hurry, hurry. Hurry. Hurry, hurry, hurry. Hurry. Hurry, hurry. All right, you got 1 minute. 1 minute. One in. Let's go. Let's go. Hurry. Pass it. Pass it. Hurry. Hurry, hurry. Dun, 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 dun. Praise Him in the morning. Praise Him at the noontime. Praise Him in the pew. Praise Him when the sun goes down. Brian. Hey, don't throw them. Don't throw them. You got to pass them. You got to pass them. You got to pass them, peanuts. You can't throw them. 30 seconds. 30 seconds. Come on. Come on. You got to pass them. You can't throw them. You got to pass them. 15 seconds. 15 seconds. Hurry, hurry, hurry. Go back there and get that one. All right, 5 seconds, 5 seconds, 4, 3, 2, 1. Beep. Sorry, got to be in the bucket. All right, Angie.
Can we count them? Oh, I think we won.
All right, you count yours. I got 1, 2. No, we got 4. All right, Angie, how many you got?
46.
Well, the boy had 47. No.
No.
Boys wasn't even close. 30. The girls won. Nuh-uh. All right, sit down, sit down, sit down. Nobody cheated. Nobody cheated. All right. Here we go. I'll put them over here. All right, that's a good game. That's a good game. I got to get busy here. Now, listen up. Listen up, Brother Baker. All right. Okay, listen, I'm going to give everybody a number, and we're going to have a thing called Let's Make a Deal. You know how to count off? All right, ladies, if you want to go back to your seats, you can now. All right, you ready? All right, I'm going to have a number. You ready? You are number 1.
2.
3.
4.
5. 6. No. 8. All right, you got your number. All right, you ready? You're number 1. 24. You were 24. 23. 24. 25. 26, 27, 28. Okay, you ready? All right, where's Miss Baker at? All right. Where's my numbers at? What'd I do with my numbers? Oh, here they are. All right, what we're going to do, we're going to draw a number. And this first number, if it's like number two, we'll take the number two boy, the number two girl. We'll just do a girl first. All right, draw a number for a girl. We're going to do two girls and one boy today.
Girl, number one.
Come up here with Brother Baker. All right, put it back in. Put it back in. Oh, draw one more for a girl. Draw one more for a girl. Hurry up.
This is a girl. Who's 23?
All right, come on. There you go. Put them back in now. Now, one more for one. We'll draw one boy.
We don't have 39.
No, we don't have 39 boys. No, we don't have 29. 18 boys.
Seven.
All right, number seven. All right, take one more. Put another. All right, here's what we're going to do. You ready? You say, who was the first number? You was the first number? Okay. Now listen, there's a prize over there behind that door. And there's a prize over here behind this door. And then there's another prize right on the other side of the piano, and there's a prize in my pocket. What would you rather have? That door behind the piano, what's in my pocket? You want what's in the pocket? You sure about that? Positive, okay? What would you like to have? You can't have the pocket. She's got it. Door, you want one behind the piano. She wants the one behind the piano. Height, what would you like, that door or that door? You want that door. Okay, we're going to get the one behind the piano first. And here it is. A can of Alpo dog food. Okay. We'll set that right up here, okay? There's yours. All right. Who got the pocket? All right, you got what door? You want that door. Okay. All right, you got your little ice chest. When you run away from home, you're good to go. Amen? And what'd you get? The pocket. Now, would you like to have what's in the pocket too? Both of you want the pocket. You do. You giving up your Alpo dog food. Okay. She don't want this dog food. Oh my, $5 bill. Well, it could have been a 20, but it's just a five. My. And you wanted the pocket? Okay, it's $2. Okay, let me go get her $2 over here. Okay. But I tell you what I'm going to let you do. We're not going to just leave you here with $2. When we get through, we'll let you get something off the table. Okay? Let's give them a good hand. Amen. Nobody chose that over there, did they? Oh, boy, that was the grand prize. I can't tell you what it is. It's too good. It's just so good. We have got some good stuff. All right. Okay, now. All right. Well, we're going to uncover the table. Oh, boy. Yeah. Oh, my. All kinds of stuff up here. This is a water gun. Hey, aren't these some cool sunglasses? For little kids. Yeah. And we got some orange drink. I like this cup. You put your ice in the middle. Keeps it cool. And you, some of you boys need one of these. Cookies. Oh boy. We have all kinds of stuff. All kinds of stuff. Ink pens. We have snack packs. We even, all right, we got socks. Girl socks. Alright. Alright. We're gonna draw four numbers. No, no. If your number was drawn for the let's make a deal, then you won't be participating in this. Okay, you ready? If we draw a 1 through 18, it'll be boy and girl. The same number.
Okay.
Okay. No, that's be okay.
10.
Number 10 and number 10. Who's 10 over here? All right, go right back there. All right, go all the way to the back. All right. There you go. 18. All right. There you go. One more. We'll do one more. Yeah. All right. Here we go. Oh.
Twelve.
Who's 12 over here? All right. Okay. All right. Now listen. You line up back there. You're going to have one. I'm going to give you a minute and a half. You listen. You come down, get what you want under the table, off the table, go back, and the next person comes. You can't leave till they get back. You got it? Now listen. Be cautious. If you, we had one year. We had a girl who was running. She slipped like to knock the wall out. So be careful. Okay. Ready? 1 minute and a half. Y'all cheer them on now, okay? All right, here we go. You're not quite ready. Got to get. All right. Oh, one item. Only one item. Now you just get one item at a time. Thank you, Brother Tommy. Ready? Minute and a half. 1 minute. Set. Go. Hurry, hurry, hurry. Hurry, hurry, hurry. All right, let's go, let's go, let's go. All right, ooh, you better hurry. Let's go. Oh, boy, he got a broke finger. There you go. I thought you were going to get that mirror. All right, let's go. Y'all moving too slow. Craig, day alive. You ought to be zooming by here now. Right, like him. There you go. Oh, he got it. Wow. There you go. 30 seconds. You got 30 seconds. Yes. There you go. Woo! All right, come on. You got 20 seconds. Hurry. 10 seconds. 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 3, 3, 2, 1. There you go. All right, there's some bags back there to put your stuff in. Wasn't that good? Let's give him a good hand. Amen. That's wonderful. All right. Now, I want to make an announcement, okay? All right, listen to Brother Baker. Listen to me. All right. You'll see all over the building, you'll see different things that says, right kind of friend, a home, godly wisdom, a talent to honor God. Now, tomorrow night at this time, we're going to have somebody here who has a talent that they've given to the Lord. And you'll meet that person tomorrow night. Some of you may have a talent that I'm not aware of. Maybe you can draw real good, like an artist. Maybe you can sing. And we'd love to hear you sing. Now, we can't let everybody do something, but if you would say, Preacher, God's given me a talent, and I'd like to share it with you, okay? tomorrow night we'll meet that person who will share with us the talent that they've given to the Lord that they have. Okay? And so that'll be tomorrow night. Now, and so now at this time, I want to share with you our Bible lesson for today. If I can put my hands on it right quick. All right. Boy. When all else fails, look straight ahead. Ten great needs. We're going to cover two of those tonight. This will be 10 things that you as a young person need in your life right now. Now, I realize adults need these too, but more so do you need it. Because at your young age, whether you be 7 years old or 17 or my age, these are 10 things, and we're going to, the very first thing is the most important thing that everybody needs, but especially you as a teenager and a young boy or girl. Number one is salvation. Say the word salvation. Salvation. Okay? Boys, you say it one time. Say it. Salvation. Girls, you say it. Salvation. Now, that's a great Bible word, salvation. Now, the Bible tells us in Psalm 68:20, it says, He that is our God is the God of what? Salvation. And unto God, the Lord, belong the issues from death. So we look at that. Our God is the God of salvation. And He can save you even unto death. Now, when you think about the word salvation, we get our word salvage from it. You ever been to a junkyard or a refining plant? In other words, if you go down to the junkyard, there'll be an old car down there and it's falling apart and needs work to it. And a guy comes in and says, I'd like to get that old car. What do you take for it? I'll give me a few bucks. He takes that car back to his place, and little by little, that old car that was no good, he begins to work on it. And he does body work on it, puts new windows in it, does the inside, the outside. It may take a while, but as the months and weeks and years go by, when he gets through with that car, brand new paint job, and he pulls it out of the garage, and folks say, my, what a beautiful car. Where did you get that at? He'd say, at the salvage yard. When I found that car, it was just a piece of junk. But I spent the time and the effort and the money on it to make it what it is now. You see, that's what God wants to do with your life. Brother Baker, my life is not that bad. My life is not like a junk pile. Well, wait a minute. You've got to think about who's looking at it and what the Bible says. So we find that salvation is in the Lord. Now, Jesus died to rescue you from your sin. The man goes down to the junkyard. That car is going to be thrown into the things that, what's it called? Crusher. And it's just going to crush it up and be no good. But that man bought it. See, sin does to you what that crusher does to that car. It destroys you. And if you die in your sin, unsalvaged, unsaved, you end up in an awful place called hell. And there is a real hell and there's a real heaven. And the only way you can be saved or have salvation is through the Lord Jesus Christ. And so we understand that Jesus died to rescue you from your sin. And we all sin. How many here, well, I don't ask you to raise your hand because I want you to confess your sins to me. There's nobody in this building that hadn't sinned. I mean, sinned a lot. And some more than others because of age. The longer you live without being saved, the more sins you have committed. So Jesus died to rescue from your sins. Sin separates you from God. And God will have nothing to do with sin. Since we had sin in our life, God has nothing to do with us as far as saving us. He wants to save us, and He will. But look what it says. Sin brings about death. Now, death is separation. My father died when I was 11 years old. And my mother has passed away since then, and a brother. Mrs. Baker's parents have passed away. Some of you have had grandmothers who... You're separated from them because death separates you from them. Now listen, sin brings death, and that's separation from God. Now God loves you and He loves me, but that sin separates us because God has nothing to do with sin. And it's nothing we can do about it because the Bible says we all have sinned and we've all come short of the glory of God. And if we die in our sins unsaved or unsalvaged, we end up away from God, eternal death in that place called hell. But that's not what God wants. God is the great rescuer. Since we can't save ourselves from our sin, God has prepared a way that you can be saved, you can be salvaged. And that's through His Son, Jesus Christ. So see? So salvation means to be what? Saved. I am saved now. I'm no longer lost. I'm no longer in the junkyard of sin. Now I am in the hands of Jesus, and He's working on me right now, each day of my life, and preparing me for the day I'll go to heaven. Right? So he's salvaging my life, putting it together, making something beautiful out of it. That guy would go get that car, and he put a new fender on it and did this, did that, reupholstered it. And when he got through, man, it's a beautiful car. Folks would say, great, hey, that's a beautiful car. What do you take for it? He said, I'm not selling that car. I got too much time and money. I love it too much. So God wants to make something beautiful out of your life. Now you listen to Brother Baker real careful. God wants to make something beautiful out of your life, and the devil wants to ruin your life. Wreck it. Keep you in the junkyard. But Jesus wants to salvage it. And so we understand that. So salvation means to be saved. You must see and know that you are lost. If you can't see that, don't know that, then you can't be. You got to say, I am a sinner, Preacher Baker. I am a sinner. I have lied. I've done some things and said some things. I've backtalked my parents. I've done this and done that. Recognize your sinfulness. And what that sinfulness does, it separates you from God. But Jesus came and died for you, paid your sin debt, that your sins could be washed away and forgiven, and you could be saved. Let me tell you a story. Back when I was in the 10th grade, some friends, me and I think three or four more guys, it was in the month of January, and we skipped school. Yeah, played hooky. We didn't go. They said, let's go back over. We went over way, way back down behind. My hometown was on the river. And way back and behind the river were a bunch of little lakes and ponds and things. And it was in January. It was an unusually warm day for January. So it was about a 45-minute walk back there. I was in the 10th grade. These other guys were older than me, so I just tagged along. One of the things says, right kind of friends said. Well, these weren't the right kind of friends. Of course, I wasn't a Christian at the time. So we get back there, and it's pretty hot, and we get on this little island, and we said, well, let's get back. And so there's a guy named Fred there. Now, Fred's he's a senior in high school. I'm in the 10th grade. And Fred's a lifeguard. Thank goodness he was. So Fred and I decided we would swim across a little piece of water to a sandbar and build a fire while the other three guys walked around and we built a fire. It's in what month? What month? The water is what? Cold. So we get in the water. It's no further than from here to that church sign, maybe 40 yards. So I take my wallet out of my pocket, put my wallet in my mouth, take my shirt off, showed my muscles. No, I didn't. Took my shirt off, put it in my hand, and we're just going to tread water. I have boots on, but I'm a good swimmer. I'm an excellent swimmer. You start swimming. Get about halfway, and I get cramps from the cold water in my warm body. Get cramps in one of my foot. And within just 10 seconds, my whole leg, I can't move my whole leg. Within 10 more seconds, I can't move this leg. And now, I've thrown my wallet away. I spit my wallet out, throw my shirt away. I'm just trying to stay up. Well, it wasn't but just a few more moments. The coldness and the crampness is on my whole body. I'm fighting to stay up. I'm drowning. I'm trying to stay up. The water is coming. I'm sinking down. I'm trying to stay up. Out of nowhere, an arm comes. Comes under my arm, under my chin, pops me up, and takes me to the sandbar. It's Fred. He's a lifeguard. He took me there. Not only did he save my life from drowning, he took me there, and since it was a warm day, he took that sand, that warm sand, and covered my body in it. You know why? Because of hypothermia. To warm my body back up. Of course, I didn't have any water in my lungs, but I could have still died. And of course, the other guys didn't know what's going on. By the time they get there, I'm getting my senses about me. Had I have died that day, listen, had I have died that day, I'd be in hell right now. I wouldn't be here. Because I was a sinner. I played ball, you name it, I played it. Very active. I was a popular young guy because I was played ball. But if I'd have died that day, I wouldn't be here now. Fred saved my physical life, covered my body in that warm sand. I'm forever grateful for Fred for coming back and getting me. I didn't care about the wallet, didn't care about the shirt. I was glad to be alive. And just as Fred reached down and pulled me up, the Lord Jesus Christ, at the age of 19, reached down spiritually and pulled me up out of my filth of sin, saved my soul. And I'm happy, happy, happy today. Glad. I'm so thankful for a friend named Fred who could have said, I can't get back to him. Fred could have said, well, Baker's on his own. And no doubt he risked his life to come and get me. Jesus reached down. He come all the way from heaven. Come down and died on the cross that you could be saved. Wow. Isn't that wonderful? So I've been saved twice. I've been saved physically from that. Then saved spiritually, which is the greatest, because of the Lord Jesus Christ. And this afternoon, while you're in this, we've had a great time and going to have some more great times this week. But the greatest thing that could ever happen to you is for you to be saved. Salvation. Then notice number two, a Bible. Well, if you're saved, you need a Bible. Amen? And I love that King James Bible. You see, the Bible is God's what? Word. And when I think about the Word of God, here it is. Boy, there's the Bible. What a wonderful book. Is there anybody here who does not have a Bible, would like to have one? You do not have a Bible? We're going to get you a Bible. Everybody needs a Bible. Now, if you have a Bible, read it. Read the Bible. Boy, look at what the Bible. The Bible is God's Word. It's the greatest book ever written. The greatest. Amen? How about this? It tells all about God and man. Hey, you read this, it'll tell you about yourself. All about you. It'll tell you about God. How He works, how He operates, how much He loves you. How your life can have purpose and meaning to it. It's a great book. How about this? It tells you how to live properly. How to live proper. You know, you being young, little kids and teenagers, learning proper ways is almost gone today. How many of you here know how to say yes, sir? Yes, ma'am. Have you young fellas, if you're sitting down somewhere and a lady walks in, what do? Tell me. You get up and let her have your seat. Open the door for a lady. I mean, there's proper ways to do that. The Bible is a book that'll tell you how to properly do things. Amen? It'll tell you how to be saved and how you can mold and make your life. And then notice this, how to handle situations. Some of you right now, even though you're young, you got some situations that's pretty rough. When I was a kid growing up, I had some rough situations. You see, my mom and dad separated when I was a little boy. My dad was a horrible drinker. He drank liquor and beer and anything else, and he'd beat my mama and throw his money away. And when I was about 7, 8, 9, 10 years old, I lived back and forth with my grandparents. I had some horrible situations. Really did. I didn't know how to handle them. I didn't know. But even as a kid, the Bible can tell you how to handle situations. It really can. Amen? And then it is the answer book. Is the answer book. The answers to life are found in this book. Not in the newspaper, not in a magazine, not on TV. The answers to life is found in this book. How to treat people. Pay your bills. Be an obedient child to your mom and dad. Honor them. Love them. Treat young men, treat young ladies right. Young ladies, be proper. Amen. And so the Bible. Everybody needs a Bible. Greatest book. I love my Bible. Amen. Now listen, I've told you the story about being saved, and how the Bible tells you how to be saved. So if you are not saved, you can be saved tonight. Tonight, if you'll see yourself as a sinner, you have sin. You'll ask Jesus to forgive you. Really? He will. He'll come into your life. He'll wash away all your sins. And He'll begin to salvage your life, give you peace and joy and something worth living for. You'll be able to understand things you've never understood before. He'll help you in your schoolwork. He'll help you with your classmates. He'll help you with every situation in your life. He'll help you. But the first step is getting saved. And the Bible says, if you believe in your heart, not your heart that beats, but your soul, if you believe in your soul, your heart, the Lord Jesus Christ, and confess with your mouth, you shall be saved. So if you believe in your heart you're a sinner, and Jesus died for you, and He'll forgive you, if you'll confess that, He'll save you. Something like this. Lord Jesus, I am a sinner. And now I fully realize my sins. If I die in my sins, I'll end up in that awful place called hell. And I don't want to go there. I want my life to be something. And would you save me, Lord Jesus? And He'll save you tonight if you want to be saved. Amen. And what I'd like for you to do, we're going to have a little word of prayer. And if you're not saved, we're going to dismiss you to your craft classes. If you'll just stay behind, Brother Baker will take the Bible and show you how you can be saved. Amen. Now, how many here are saved? Raise your hand real high. You are saved. I'm not looking. Okay, put them down. Now, if you couldn't raise your hand, why don't you get saved tonight? Right now. Because those who raise their hand, they want you to be saved. Nobody's going to say, what about them? And that's the greatest thing in the world. They'll be praying for you. So if you'll just stick around, I'll take the Bible, show you how to be saved. Amen. Those of you who are saved, would you like to see somebody get saved? Say amen.
Amen.
See there? All right. So we're going to pray for you. Lord Jesus, we sure have had a good time tonight, and activities, but Lord, now is the most important time of the whole night. It's, Lord, for somebody maybe to be saved. Could be a teenage boy or girl, could be a 9 or 12-year-old, even a 7 or 8-year-old. I'm glad children can be saved and adults and teenagers too. So I pray, Holy Spirit, you'll speak to their heart. And they'll just linger around a little bit and stay behind and get the greatest thing in the world. They'll get salvation from you. Please do it in their life. In thy name I pray. Amen. All right, very quietly, go to your classes where you're... If you'd like to be saved, just stay and we'll talk to you, okay? Amen. Just go right out. There you go.